Let's talk about the trial. Some of the victims I've represented found it to be a really traumatic experience that brings everything back. How were you at the trial?
Oh, yeah, I've never been out of my comfort zone. I've never... My shakes, I couldn't control my body at all. Like, it was awful. And for that point, I've never spoken to people about it. You know, I've kind of, for the majority of our relationship, I'd never spoken. So for me, talking about it all, but talking about it in front of people have just made it just seem like, oh, my God, as if he's done this to me. Like, I've never actually felt it. But going on of everything he'd done, it just done so much, and I was just felt weak of allowing him to do that to me.
Victims I represent find that when they're in the box, the defence tries to trip them up, tries to catch them out.
Oh, yeah, yeah. When I was first in hospital, I took done a statement with the police, and then when I come out of hospital, about two and a half months after, I'd done a video evidence, and I'd got a date or a time wrong, and, you know, they were picking that up, going to the jury, Miss Bellis is lying, you can't get the times wrong, calling me a liar.
You've had acid thrown on the side of your face, and you've got these horrendous burns, and you were called a liar at that trial?
Yeah. Yeah, they're awful.
That's outrageous, and it makes me so angry to listen to that.
It made me feel like I was wrong for opening up and telling everyone everything what I'd done, because I was getting called a liar, and it took me that much to tell the police everything. Like, in my head I was saying, don't tell anything, and my mouth just done the talking, but then they're telling me I'm a liar, and it was a horrible experience.
What was the sentence, and how did you feel about that?
Anthony got life minimum of 12 years, and I weren't happy with it. Basically, he got done for 7 accounts of stuff: GBH, false imprisonment, conspiracy for stab, conspiracy for ass attack, other stuff, harassment. And I just think for the ass attack alone should have been that sentence, not let alone everything else. You know, that's my life gone. My life has been changed forever, and... You know, I've got to deal with it. Every day is a struggle for me, whereas he's going to do his time, come out and have a normal life, whereas every day is a struggle for me, and I've got to deal with that for the rest of my life, you know.
But this crime story has one last devastating twist.
And your actual attacker, the man that threw the acid on you, he got 4 years, but he's actually out in 2, and he's out right now.
On good behaviour, yeah.
He can come back and live in your area. How does that make you feel?
I don't think he should be allowed. I don't think he's got that right to come back. Like, I'm still struggling daily. I'm still going to hospital, whereas he's done his time and expects a normal life. And why would I want to, you know, go to town and potentially bump into the person that's ruined my life or, you know, changed my life? He should never be allowed back here.